Underdog. In the heart of the Arizona desert, four high school students decided to sign up for an underwater robotics club. Their goal? Build a robot to compete in a college-level contest. It would be colleges like the elite MIT versus Carl Hayden High School, where 9 in 10 kids live below the poverty line. It was pretty clear to the club's advisors who the underdog was.
We were going with the mindset that we were going mainly as observers.
As an exploratory type of thing. And if we just beat one college, that would be phenomenal.
The Carl Hayden team started meeting after school. There was Oscar, who was ambitious and took charge from the start.
I would make a competition out of anything.
Christian was the brains of the operation.
I was a loner. I really didn't like people very much.
Luis was the strong, dependable guy who didn't like to talk.
We had the leader, the brain, the muscle, and then there was me, you know. So, what intrigued me was that there was two there. I get to destroy things.
They scraped together $800 for materials and made the robot's frame out of PVC pipe. They used 5 small electric motors to propel it and to run the robot remotely, off-the-shelf joysticks. The glue they used to piece it together smelled so bad they named the robot Stinky. When the Carl Hayden team got to the competition, it felt like another world.
I had never seen that much white people.
Yeah, we definitely felt out of place.
And the other robots?
They were like pieces of underwater jewelry.
I was like, man, as long as we don't finish last.
Then came the first big test, extracting liquid from a barrel. The mighty MIT's robot tried repeatedly and failed. And Stinky?
We fitted a copper hose pipe in there.
Once we actually got it in, that was a very big moment for us.
To everyone's surprise, those winning moments kept accumulating, including an expert presentation on their robot in English, their second language. Finally, it came time to hand out the awards.
Maybe we had a shot at third place.
But third place went to a community college. Second place went to
MIT.
And the winner?
Carl Hayden.
The whole room was screaming because we were the high school team.
We're so excited.
I was just floating, I think.
Oscar, Cristian, Luis, and Lorenzo had their ups and downs after high school. But their achievement inspired something big at Carl Hayden.
Or I could just duct tape the two ends together.
Kids lined up for the robotics club, excited to study math and science and go on to college.
The 2004 team showed us that it was possible.
I want to be an aerospace engineer, solve the energy crisis.
Work on semiconductors and make them go faster.
Prosthetics for kids.
The next household robot.
I want to be an astronomer.
No matter what background you come from or where you are, you can do what you set your mind to do.